you know, every instrument's going to be different inside, but there's usually a very easy way to remove one of these banks of reeds. In this case, this particular instrument just has a couple little catch latches here, and you can just pull it back, and then you want to be gentle, but then you should be able to just lift that bank of reeds out, and there it is, okay? And so you can see now we can look into the accordion and see kind of those holes here, right? And these are the holes that open and close when you push different keys on the keyboard. So let me see if I can make some of those open. Actually, I might need to press kind of one of these bank selectors. Yeah, there we go. Okay, so those are the holes that open and close, so we'll set that aside now. So here's our bank of reeds, and this is basically just like a giant harmonica. And let's look at this a little bit closely. Actually, a small harmonica is built the same way. Each one of these metal elements here is a different reed. It's a different note of the scale, okay? And the reed itself is, I'm going to be real gentle doing this, the reed itself is this sort of little tongue of metal, you can see, that can sort of freely move in and out of kind of a rectangular opening. See that? So I'm kind of using the tip of the needle nose pliers, but this is the reed itself. Even though, you know, if you get a replacement reed, you get this whole piece, but the part that vibrates is this little piece here. So these are actually steel reeds here, but, you know, they make brass reeds also. Steel reeds kind of have a brighter sound. You'll also see there are these little flaps of leather. And what these flaps of leather are they're valves that basically close the reed that's on the other side, okay? So in other words, if we were to take this out, and, well, we probably shouldn't do it because they kind of seal them with beeswax around there, so they kind of, we could take one of these out if we wanted to, but we'd have to seal it in again. This reed has another reed just like this right behind that piece of leather. And at the same time, right behind this reed, there's another piece of leather. And what that leather does is it acts as a valve so that air can only go through that reed one way or the other. So remember when I told you how, you know, a free reed instrument has air going over it both ways? So this reed, this whole sort of piece of metal, will be used for one note, but one of them will vibrate when on the pulling the bellows, while this piece of leather lays down flat and prevents the other reed from vibrating. And then when I squeeze the bellows, the reed that's underneath that piece of leather will vibrate, whereas a piece of leather on the other side of here is going to prevent that one from vibrating.